Chapter 12, Waiting Period. Jessie wanted to have fun. She really did. But it seemed like the more she tried, the less she had. First, the drive to the beach took 2.5 hours because of traffic. Jessie felt the car lurching. Forward, stop. Memo to myself, said Mr. Moriarty. Never go to the beach on the Sunday of Labor Day weekend, especially when there's been a heat wave for more than a week. In the back seat, Jessie and Megan played license plate tag and magnetic bingo and 20 questions, but by the end of the car ride, Jessie was cramped and bored. Then, the beach parking lot was full, so they had to go park half a mile away and walk. Then, the beach was so crowded that they could hardly find a spot for their blanket. Then, Megan said the water was too cold and she just wanted to go in up to her ankles. She kept squealing and running backwards every time a gentle ripple of wave came her way. What fun was that? Sure, the water was cold. It was the North Shore. It was supposed to be cold. That's why it felt so good on hot days like this. When Jessie and Evan went to the beach, they would boogie board and body surf and skimboard and throw a screaming scrunch ball back and forth the whole time. They loved to stay in the water until their lips turned blue and they couldn't stop shaking. Then they'd roast themselves like weenies on their towels until they were hot and sweating again. And then they'd go right back in. Now that was fun at the beach. Megan liked to build sandcastles and collect shells and play sand tennis and read magazines. That's all fine, thought Jessie, but not going in the water? That's crazy. The ride home was itchy and hot. Jessie had sand in all the places where her skin rubbed together, between her toes, behind her ears, and between her cheeks of her bottom. And somehow, she'd gotten sunburned on her back, even though Miss Moriarty had smeared her all over with thick, goopy sunscreen twice. Jessie didn't even have the patience for 10 questions, let alone 20. But Megan didn't get that Jessie didn't feel like talking. She kept trying to get her to take a quiz in a teen magazine. If Evan had been there, he would have kept quiet or maybe hummed a little. Jessie liked it when Evan hummed. As they turned onto Damon Road, Megan asked, "Are you feeling sick?" In fact, she was. For the past half an hour, Jessie had been imagining walking in the door and facing Evan. She had been feeling sicker and sicker with every mile that brought her closer to home.